Watts Garcia. Race to nine, handshake, and this is going to be some good stuff here.
And when you're winning all day, of course you're going to be put on the stream table.
That's what you have to do.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Somebody play some One Pocket.
Look at these guys. Wow.
Frozen.
Wow.
Frozen.
Facho froze them up. Facho froze them up. There we go. So this is going to be a very entertaining and good match, you know. You got Mitch just coming off the wins. You know the guy?
Yeah.
He makes balls. You know what I mean?
He does. The guy can shoot.
Yes. You can play him some pool. Yeah, I think comparisons to Jason Shaw would be decent. You know what I mean?
I just like, there's no fancy stroke. Right. That's just shoot balls, make them.
Just let's make
you have to punch a ball, you punch it.
If I have to bang it, I bank it.
Yeah.
And Fox changes breakup. I'm looking for a safe behind a 3-9 here, Aaron.
The only thing I don't like is that when that 2 hits the back of the 5, it just stays right there. And if you don't play the safety correctly, you leave a shot.
Of course.
I think it's really easy to miss that safe. Or you can lock him up. Or you can do that.
That guy plays one hole, man.
Yep.
You put that ton of English he had on that ball, he made sure he was going to get over there.
We got to put a highlight reel together.
Oh,
a
Mez, sure.
West State.
Oh, yeah. There's enough shots.
Oh, yeah. I remember one time Jeff Ignacio gets up and just hits a shot, draws it. Like you remember which one I'm talking about?
Yeah,
from the side
pocket? Disgusting. Yeah.
You were dying laughing.
That was insane.
Dying.
Man. Insane, man.
The guy cool is, he doesn't even look like he's trying. He just hits it and the ball does what he wants.
Ignacio is ridiculous.
Yeah. And there's 10 other kids that play the same speed. That was an excellent shot by Foch.
Yeah, he just came there, came with the bank.
Yeah.
Correct pace.
Yep. I think he's already thinking about the 7 ball. Or, man.
You cannot
I have so
do
much
that.
Power.
Yeah, you
the
cannot
wizardry.
Do that.
The commentator curse. It was really strange, though, because he hit that pretty good, and he barely clipped the point.
Mm-hmm.
So you got to be careful.
Yeah.
On diamonds, they've got deep shelves and
exactly.
Really sharp corners.
Exactly.
And things don't just fall.
Yeah. I really think Mitch is ducking here, but he might stiff this bank.
I think you can hit it with a little bit of draw, just slightly below the outside, and fire it right in. And go straight towards the 5.
Yeah, he's got room.
Yep. I think that's what he tried.
Yeah.
But he's been hitting those really hard cross side banks all day.
Stiffs them.
And not been hitting that bank.
Right. Because when you hit them hard, you change the angle when you hit them hard to soft.
Yeah, absolutely.
So he has the hard angle dialed in. He's got it dialed. Foch looking to get a roll here.
Played that all day. Better get off the table, Foch.
Look at
if
Foch.
It falls, it's your fault.
Foch looking at him like, what you got?
Yeah. So the rule is, I believe, now if it falls, right?
Right.
Then it's considered like an act of God, and then
it comes back up.
It comes back up.
Yeah, and goes right to where it's at.
Yeah. But if Foch is still at the table when it drops, then I think it's his fault, right? There's no 5-second rule. It's who's,
right.
It's who's ownership of the table.
Yeah.
Yeah. Or who has control.
Right.
We had that happen with Justin Marks. He was at the table for a while, and the ball fell, like, 9
right.
seconds later.
Right.
And they didn't know what to do. Jump kick, which he almost contacted the 4. Failed to, and I'm fairly certain that Foch is out here, even though the 7 ball, not easy.
Wow. You know, the freeway is empty because it's still closed.
and try to get as perfect as possible.
Mm-hmm. And these are the shots he's not been hitting well, because you see, because he knows it. Because now, this little rebound angle, you got to hit this ball pure.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
It's one of the shots I practice the most.
Especially on the diamond, man. See?
You can't hit it full on Brunswick. That goes in, no problem. You have to cut it.
He didn't hit that ball bad, did he?
He hit it center, and it came off the rail a little bit. And from that angle, it never goes.
Right.
You got to intentionally cut that ball to the face. You can't touch the rail on the way in.
And look at,
Mitch
is going to take advantage of anything you give him.
It's the style of play that Foch has that does not function well on this table.
Right. You're watching the Mets West State Tour stop number 5. Bull Shooters in Phoenix, Arizona. Rahan and Aaron Conway sweating to semifinals. Winner plays Tim Daniel. And if Mitch Ellerman wins, it'll be all Arizona finals.
Good for them.
Yeah,
I'm glad.
For sure.
Good for them. What a wish for a little bigger turnout, but it's a difficult time of the year. It's super hot.
Super hot.
Everybody's playing in Vegas.
6 hours away. Yeah, that's what I think. Vegas,
less,
too.
Less people California people because we're so far away.
Yeah. It's all good, but you know what? We might have a small field. We have some high caliber playing here.
Yeah, absolutely.
I'm loving it.
Absolutely.
You know, and we still add the same money. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Pool is a really respectful game, and I think we always try to keep it consistent.
You know what I'm saying?
I know you like to tie up balls.
I tie them up.
I like to push to traps.
Nope.
Forget
that. Tie it up.
Because I don't want to get back to the table and have to deal with a tie up ball.
You know what I'm saying? Little balls get tied up, and then you have to do something. See? Hello, Mr. Tied Up Ball.
Yeah, so let's say he gets ball in hand, or let's say he gets out of the safety. Then he's got to negotiate that 2 ball.
So what? I'm still alive. Because dude could run out on you.
That's true.
You know what I mean?
True. You leave him a bank and he runs out and gets a little confidence.
Yeah. And he's out on some easiness. No,
Sal
make you work.
We'll double bank this ball all day. No problem.
Sal hits those banks very well.
I was playing in bank pool and I asked him, I was like, hey, what do you do here? Yeah, just double bank it, Aaron. Just easy. Just double bank it. And then I'd laugh at him and he'd get up and he'd fire it in.
Of course.
I think that's significantly higher percentage.
And got him too.
Yes, he did.
And he said, all right.
Pretty good crowd of people watching.
Yeah. Knowledgeable too. The knowledgeable Arizona crowd.
Yeah.
You know, they clapped when they saw a stellar play.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? They know. Are you kidding me?
A lot of the people here are in leagues.
Yeah.
There's a lot of bar tables here. There's a lot of people playing for fun.
Right.
And they still know what good shots there are on bad shots.
Absolutely. Foss might just bump his 7 here. He says, no need.
It's a great play, the 3 in the side, 4 in the side. 5 in the same corner as the 2 ball.
Foz just jumping. I'm like, oh man, I didn't know I hit that with that stroke. Now he's got to go around.
Yeah.
And he's got to hope he don't hit the 7.
I agree. Go in between the 6-5 maybe. Soft spin it.
Yeah, I mean, Foz has all the fancy stuff. Yeah, you know what I mean?
He doesn't bomb it though. He tries to get really clean.
But the thing I'm saying is like, you got to get on the game, you know what I mean?
Yeah. Does it pass the 6 for the
I can't tell. I mean, if it does, he's shooting it.
Yeah.
Ellerman looking at that, coming across the face of the 3.
It was a good safety in a difficult situation by Foch. Simple, worked really well. I think Mitch was intentionally looking to come off the free ball.
Yeah, that's exactly what he played. He played it. pointed right to it.
Yeah. That was a good shot. It was a good attempt.
I like his little aiming system.
Mitch?
Yeah.
Yeah. Ah, see, Foch just figured out the speed. You don't punch that ball and come back out.
You hit that ball.
If you hit it a little bit softer, it doesn't catch the point as much.
Right.
Just gotta adjust his game a little bit. Mm-hmm. A little nicer speed.
You gotta play more angles.
You gotta get a little bit thinner.
Mm-hmm.
A little, little more angle.
It all goes up. Right. Very sexy shot.
That's back to Vilmos with that slow spin.
Yep.
Yeah, see, Foch is hitting them. I don't know if he's doing it subconsciously. Like, his brain is just adjusted. He realizes that everything takes it's a little bit better to spin and roll it in.
You got to take that pace off that ball.
If
you can't
pound balls.
Right.
His diamond
tails, You're not doing it.
You got to hit them so good.
That's right. We'd like to thank our sponsor, Andy Billiard Cloth. You can check him out at andybilliardcloth.com.
I think Mitch and Oscar are pretty much the only people here today that I've seen really punching balls hard on these tables
and
still making them. Yeah.
Right.
That four ball that Mitch had earlier.
Yeah. Yeah, for sure.
Punched it and had the seven come out and run into the five.
And there it is.
That was amazing.
Yeah, it was beautiful. Let's see if Potts is changing up his break spot.
I don't think Mitch is going to say anything, but that's a borderline soft break.
Borderline?
You think that's not borderline?
I don't think he... To me, like, you have to really try.
To
like,
soft break?
Yeah,
he's annoying.
He was controlling. He playing the one in the side and trying to get the...
Yeah.
He didn't, you know what I mean? I've seen, I watched Dennis do it.
Yeah.
You can tell. Because they make four balls.
You're talking about Arpoia?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
I think Oscar's only criteria for soft break, if someone is actually doing it and they're being like malicious about it and annoying, is you gotta have three balls in the kitchen.
Yeah, 3 points. Yeah. That's the rule. WPA, 3 points.
Yeah.
Three balls
in the kitchen or three balls pocketed.
Yeah.
Or a mix of.
Yeah. Oscar told Corey Duell, listen, just don't do it here.
Oh, Duell. That's who you're talking about. I thought you said Dennis.
No, Corey Duell.
Duell. Yeah.
And here we go. Mitch misses a kick, and this is a good opportunity here for Mr. Foch.
Yeah, Corey is...
He's a monster.
He is a monster.
I would put Corey Duell in the Hall of Fame right now.
Yeah.
No, it's not even, let's just remember his reign of terror.
Oh, yeah.
With the Sardo and the soft break. No. What did he do?
He demolished
people.
Conducted himself.
You know what? It's okay. It's okay. I don't think about that. I think about your accomplishments of what you did.
Corey's probably the most creative American player.
He is the most creative.
Yeah.
There's nobody close.
Yeah.
Corey Duell is a monster.
He does some of the most amazing shots I've ever
seen. Listen, when people change the rules because of what you do... Then you talk to me, right?
Yeah, and I remember watching
I break so good, you're going to change the rules.
Yeah,
so I can't win.
I remember watching an interview, and he said, I just wanted to play perfect, and they stopped me from doing that.
Come on.
Yeah.
Come on, man. Insane. Then he plays 8-ball, racks all the solids on one side, well, it's all the stripes on one side.
Before I did that?
Yes.
He's hilarious.
He interprets the rules.
He make the rules better, then.
And he
had
made
to do that for the U.S. Open.
Yes, he did.
They had to do that for the U.S. Open.
Yes, he did.
Didn't have to change where they were racking the 8-ball.
Yep. Nice hit by Mr. Elliman. Sorry we got a little sidetrack here, but pool is so, so inviting. So right here, Facho had a good chance to lock him up. You know what I mean? Trying to get some cheese here.
Yeah, absolutely.
You know what I mean? Trying to get it in.
I can't tell if he's got the angle to push the 4 out and go behind the 5-8. Like, jack up a little bit? That looks like it's what he's doing.
Yeah.
I I think he tried to just miss
it
slightly.
Yeah, he did. And left him straight.
The Fortunator.
Look at this Mitch, man. This guy,
he does not care.
You can tell when he lines up how his lineup looks.
It's over.
Yes, he just looks very dangerous. That's what he looks like. You know? And he's another one. Even though he plays good,
it looks good.
A good coach, Nick Varner or somebody, he goes up 2-3 balls.
Oh, with Mitch?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Nick Varner or somebody like that? One of those cool guys?
Just mentally. Sal's got so much experience. You give him Sal and you tell him, okay, this is what you do in this situation. I've been in this situation. Yeah. Here's how you play this.
I'm telling you, I would snatch him up in a minute. In a hot minute, I would.
That would be so dangerous. If you had Sal's little moving banking game, little touchy running the ball this way,
don't need a lot.
Safety game.
You don't need a lot. Nice. And he's a guy just shoots straight, man.
He's got top quality shooting skills.
Yes.
Well, I'll see you later, buddy. Hey, okay, dude. Take care.
Good to see you, buddy. Drive careful, my man.
Have a good day.
You too.
All right. And we go. We tied at 2-2. I'd like to thank our sponsor, Aramith Balls and Simona's Cloth.
What are we going to do with this? We're going to have to leave. Is he going? Yeah, we can.
Who's here? He's on the way to California. It's like a 2-1 race 350. But Chris Byers got to leave at 4 tomorrow. We don't know what to do with him. What is this? No, because we're taking off tonight. You have a room tonight? Let him know when he gets some of the action. He's a really nice kid. We take care of our own.
We might as well watch it because it's only like 3.
All right, and Mitch Ellerman doing what he's doing. He's just trying to stay in control right here. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Made a little face. He doesn't like how straight and close to the rail he is.
Right.
So I think he'll... Ooh! I forgot. It's Mitch Ellerman. My bad.
That's beautiful. He just has such a pure power game.
Yeah, absolutely. I think he does a little draw one rail.
You know, I've never saw Earl really play in person when he was there. You know, maybe somebody could have met. That's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
Like, and better.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah,
like Earl just beat
everybody.
People into submission.
Yeah.
With his shot making.
I don't want to play, and he goes, I'll give you the 8. And then you play, and he kills you. And then you go, oh, I'll give you the 6. And then you play, and he kills you. He just shoots
overwhelms you with power.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
And then after Earl played those couple races to 100, he had the Masters one a lot later in life, and the first one, the Color of Money match.
Yeah.
His safety game from Ephraim went up so much.
Oh, he was amazing.
And now when he plays these young kids and he hits them with this lock-up safety,
don't think he's going to do it.
No.
Mitch Ellerman is on a mission right now. I'm telling you that right now.
Yeah. And I can totally see Mitch being at that same level.
Nice.
So much fun to watch.
Guy just, you know, when you just get up and run out, that's what it is.
Yeah.
Nothing you can say about that. I thank our sponsor, CSI, Q Sports International, Ozzy Reynolds, Stephen Kwan, Mark Griffin, doing your thing.
It's not over yet, but if this happens to go Mitch's way, Tim's got to put up a big fight.
Tim, you know, styles make games.
Yeah.
And right now, Mitch Ellerman's style is winning.
Yeah,
you know what his style is?
I
make balls. You don't. That's what his style is.
And he is running for first
man.
Place.
Bacho. And the thing is about it too, you know, when you just give him an open opportunity where he doesn't have to negotiate anything really tough.
Putting some fire in Mitch.
It's easy. That's what I'm talking about.
And winning an event like this, or I can't say winning it, but just winning this many games yet.
Yeah.
Is going to put a lot of fire in Mitch. And it would be great to see him travel a little bit more.
Yeah. Yep.
Second place money ain't bad. That's for sure.
Any money is free money.
Even if he quits now, third, second place money.
Any money is free money. But it's good to like. I like being able to watch this game.
Yeah. It's a great game.
Look at him. He's on point right now. He was over-rolling those balls before. Now he's getting perfect. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Do you see the level going up?
Yeah, he's like that little knob on the guitar, the amps.
Yes.
That like he just went from 8 to 9.
Right. You see now he's on the right side of the ball, and he just rolls right down. He's making this look like tic-tac-toe.
You like know what I'm saying?
You see what I'm saying?
Like later in life when you figured it out and you just destroy everybody?
Yes. Because before it was a little bit of Macho Man.
Yeah.
You know, making killer shots and perfect. Running out. Now he's getting perfect and just tapping these balls in the hole. Just beautiful play, man. I love it. And Mitch Elwoman is definitely fast and loose.
Yeah, he's on fire right now.
Yeah, so playing phenomenal. And you know, Frost got an uncharacteristic bump into this, you know, and scratched, bumped the cue ball in the hole.
But he didn't hit it clean.
Yeah.
You gotta hit it dead center. And Mitch is about to do that. He's gonna hit it dead center. And last time he was making 2-3 balls and getting shape.
Yeah, he broke really well yesterday. And that three ball went in and came back out. He hit a hair too hard. If this 6 ball comes in,
1-9.
Oh man. Fox is hating life right now.
Yeah.
He can't make it.
The 7's got him.
He can't make it.
I think he's going to push to a trap, though.
I mean, I don't know if this is a... He's in trouble.
Because that's such not an easy 1-9 to make.
Yeah, no, he's in trouble.
I would push to somewhere to...
I'm moving to 9.
Annoy
Fox. Let you kick away. I'm not a real fan of leaving combos hanging out. Yes, because now you can't play it on the side. You have to play something, you know, difficult here. So, good move by Mr. Mitch. That's what I'm talking about. Don't be a hero.
That's interesting.
I know it's crazy, but I wonder if there's room. Hit the one in the face, carry him to the 9, and bank it.
Bank the what? The 9?
9, yeah.
No.
I'd be sick.
No.
No?
No. Crazy.
Yeah? What'd you say? What'd you say?
That's crazy. I would never do that.
I'll make you dance to the beat, son.
It didn't happen.
Oh, I'm so sorry. Did I just call that crystal?
Did that happen?
Did I call that crystal?
I was like, you made some of these.
My bad.
It was a decent call, I guess.
I get lucky every once in a while.
The second you said it, and then he jacked up, I was like, oh, please don't make me look bad. That was an excellent call.
Thank you, brother.
What the fuck?
Get hooked to get a hand shoe. James Hand Shoe out of Waco, Texas. The best three-piece jump cue on the market. That was sick right there. You know?
Yeah.
It's just such a blessing today. This whole weekend just been like just amazing.
You've just been humiliating your co-announcers.
No, man. You the man. I like you. You hang.
It's great.
Exciting. You know what I mean? It's so.
We've had 3 or 4 matches that have been extremely
Chris
exciting.
Chris.
That was
Grande
huge.
and Mitch
the
won.
The first time and the rematch.
And a rematch. Oscar, Tim Daniels, Fodge. You know, it's beautiful, man. I love it, man. I love this show.
A lot of really good stuff.
I got a question for you, Rob.
Yeah, buddy.
Is Grande a 7?
No.
It
was Super Grande. Super Grande. He's his name. Yeah, for sure.
He is now?
Definitely
was
8. No, we got to move. He'll
move
be 8. Yeah,
move
for sure.
He was a 7 this year,
he
played real solid.
Yeah.
He was very unassuming, and he played great.
Even if he didn't make the shots the same,
yes.
As an 8, his knowledge is totally 8, almost 9 speed.
Yeah.
The way that he's playing stuff.
Right. It was beautiful. Yes, his knowledge. His knowledge is an 8 for sure.
Yeah.
No,
nine. Yeah, mouth is a nine. Execution is an eight.
I'm sure when he was younger, he would have been
a monster. Because the guys who I know who he's talking about, those guys all play pool, buddy.
Oh, no.
What's the matter with this guy? He almost had Facho in a lockbox.
Yeah, he butchered that one.
Yeah.
he banked the one in, made the two, and I think he got there in the free ball. Let's see what happened.
Yeah. Facho's going to put him Juice Crew All-Star right here. Facho has to be a little tired.
It's a trap, man. My man Foch, that was a trap. You have no idea. It's gonna play. It's one of those traps that sets in later.
That is true.
Kicks in later.
I've never seen Foch hit balls like that. So.
Nah,
you know what I mean?
He's just not feeling it. I think he really does not like the tables. He's mentioned this a few times.
So it's got him a little deflated too.
Yeah, it's getting in his
getting head. A little way out.
Yeah.
I'm sure people say I don't like this golf course when they have to play.
Oh, I'm sure. Yeah, but when you're paying millions of dollars, I'm going to put in a lot of hours on that golf
course. Listen, my pride is worth more than millions of dollars. I'm playing.
Yeah, of course.
You know what I mean?
But I think if this was a 100,000 added event, you'd see people traveling to this pool room to be playing on these tables.
Listen, yeah. You're right.
I heard there's a pro event going on with 100,000 added.
In Canada?
That's what I'm talking about?
The Canada?
It's supposed to be a tour. It's a pro tour.
Yeah, the Canada stuff or something.
It's 100,000 added.
Good.
It's amazing for pool.
I hope so.
Mitch is doing his job.
Mitch is straight on his job.
Yeah, he is. This is classic professional level pool.
Right.
You get out 100% of the time on open racks. You run out quickly. All your decisions are efficient. You're on the correct side of the ball.
It is what it is. It's the Men's West State Tour. Sponsored by Mez Cues, Mez Professional Cues, the best production cue in the business, bar none. If you'd like to try a Mez Cue, make your way down to any of the following tour stops and ask to use the demo cue. It is what it is.
I think the races next time should be to the age.
Yeah.
And divided by two.
You guys are crazy. All right, Mitch is looking like he's going to cut this one down the corner, smooth it around, and get on downtown.
A lot of the times I forget, I think, I'll just run into the two ball.
Right.
And I end up flipping it out and it comes up table a little bit, and I hook myself. I think you should shoot this like there's no two ball. I think that's perfect.
I'm gonna like that.
Yeah. You just shoot it like there's no two ball. You don't try to hit it because you like where it is.
You know, with all his firepower, he does have a lot of finesse.
Yeah.
You know what
absolutely.
I mean?
Absolutely. Just like Jason. Jason has placed very high in the one pocket at Derby City. He can totally finesse balls. When your stroke is that consistent, you have no problem doing it.
You just make balls. It's no like Ann Cardone would say, though, you're not playing one pocket, you're playing straight pool.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
This guy just does not care, man. For real?
And when you
that's
make,
what happens?
When you make balls, though, every time you make something, you at least give yourself a chance to make another one.
And then he hits a ball, super good like that.
Yeah.
When you're rolling, you're rolling.
Left-handed, force it over.
Hit that ball so fast, I guess he wanted to trick himself into not thinking he was shooting lefty. He wanted to cheat on himself. He said, this is righty, I swear. Yeah, come on, man. Wow.
What did he say?
Fox just said, Mitch. He said, Mitch, you know this is the big table, right? Exactly. He said, because he's acting like it's a bar box. But, you know, Mitch is doing his job. He's just making balls.
Mitch said, I can't get any shape, but I can shoot some.
Yes.
Yeah.
Juicito, my main man. Oh, look at that.
Oh, he's pulling a Shane.
Yeah, he tried to get
pulling a
little
a
fancy.
This is where you break and run seven racks. You play safe and break and run another seven racks. And then the second that you don't have a shot, you just lock him up. You just mm-hmm. squeeze him for everything he has.
Mm-hmm.
That was an excellent kick. And he got...
Did he get him? Oh, no, boy.
I don't think that goes.
Two-railer coming up. Safe city. Two-railer coming up.
Oh, my goodness.
Safe city.
Oh, my goodness.
Mitch Ellerman making me look smart over here.
Hit that so good.
Yeah. Catches the tangent line right in the corner. You know what's
going to happen.
Exactly. You know that saying? The balls always know who's winning.
Yeah.
You know?
That's why you gotta slow down and be
right.
Extra.
Yes.
Extra.
You can't
with all
press.
Your
you can't press.
To address that boosty match, you just gotta respect those older players. You cannot discount older players.
Zangle? Huh.
That's
yeah.
I know everybody thinks he's old. He's not gonna be able to beat Danny. But you cannot discount players like that. I don't care how old they are.
It's Chohan.
It's not
Chohan
Danny,
and
it's
Boosty.
Chohan and Boosty.
Yeah.
I don't care who it is. You can never discount Boosty. There's a lot of people saying that Boosty's just gonna get robbed, and I think that's silly to say that.
We'll find out. Meanwhile, Ellerman's just handling business here, looking to float over, play to five in the same corner. You know, and when the balls are open and available like this and you're a shooter, this is like target practice.
He's unstoppable. Right?
You know what I mean? This is target practice. He's, you know, he's not holding anything. He's getting to let loose on his stroke.
And he's clearly
you know
got
what I mean?
The speed down.
Yes.
Yeah. I think Oscar would have been the only one to be able to shut this down. Tim's got to really come with some work.
Yeah, because if you make this guy's hungry, man.
He's capable, but this is a next level pool.
This guy's taking your lunch money every day.
You kill it in and get 3 inches away, perfect. That's perfect.
And Mitch Ellerman making it look simple, man. You know. Making it look simple, making moves. Once again, I'd like to thank my man, Tony Rodriguez of Remax Gold Coast Realtors in Ventura, California. If you're looking for some real estate, contact my man, Tony Rodriguez.
First time today I've seen him not break well, and it happens to turn out exceptionally
makes four,
well.
Makes six balls and doesn't break well.
I want you to bet this gets slammed into the side pocket.
100 miles an hour?
100.
How about you back cut it and kill it?
Nope. No way. Watch
back
this.
Cut,
slam, it. Slam it. He just pointed at the spot he wanted to be at.
Oh, stop.
It's going to go, hi-ya. Not the slam I was expecting.
Yeah.
Not the slam I was expecting, but still perfect. Make the jokes. It's not. not pool that you're gonna beat anytime soon unless you're a 9. Go around the 9 ball. Ooh. Happened to work out very well.
Of course it did. He looked at that pocket. He said,
"You notice how he didn't punch that?
Right.
Yep. Last time he would have tried to push that all the way over and come out.
Yeah.
And now he's hitting it more at like the table speed.
Yeah. Yeah. And there he goes. And he's on the hill and goes a little slight clap there because it's just like he's just running away. Man, these guys are just moving. They're moving so fast. I got to jump to the sponsors. Like, thank the official rack sponsor of the Mets West State Tour, the Turtle Rack, available in groups of two. The Turtle Rack.
Yeah, Mitch is taking, like, less than 2 minutes. Every time Foch makes a mistake or if Mitch ever breaks, he just takes less than 2 minutes.
Yeah, it is.
I hope Sal's watching this. He would love to see a player like this.
Absolutely.
Just playing smart, playing clean, just running balls out.
Yep.
Actually, I don't want to see Mitch work with any other pro player. It wouldn't be fair for anybody else. Gotta keep the secrets to ourselves. I agree, Rob. I think you are going to do a lot.
Yeah, we ain't messing around, Aaron. You know me. I ain't messing around. Just like Mitch Edelman right here. He's playing, man, it's phenomenal right now. The only person beats Mitch is Mitch right now.
Yeah.
Look at this, man. This guy's just on autopilot. And he's like, I bumped this ball. I can't see it.
Here. I think he is going to kick this in.
Oh, man.
This is at least I know for Sal, this is a very high percentage kick. Because it's close to the rail.
Mm-hmm.
You can hit it really full. And get it to slide just a little bit so you can still play the 7. Ooh.
When it rains.
It pours.
And it pours on you. And Fox is going, I got rolled on all day. Daniels rolled me to death. Now this Ellerman guy, because he can't shoot, he's just going to luck me to death.
Oh, you can't say that. You cannot say that.
Ellerman is playing the best pool of them all
now. If you're making every ball,
come on,
you're going to get lucky every once in a while.
He's making this look like, you know. That's love.